important facts about your metabolism that you should know. When it comes to dieting, exercise, and overall just trying to lose weight and maintaining your health, you might hear the word metabolism come up a lot. The metabolism is the process which the human body turns the food you eat into energy you can use, and plays an important role in managing your body's weight. However, not everybody understands how exactly human metabolism works, which can result in many people having misunderstandings and misconceptions about their own metabolisms. Today, the purpose of the video is to clear up some of these misconceptions by answering some of the most popular questions about our metabolisms, in order to help you make the most of your weight loss plan. Before we start though, give your index finger a workout by clicking on the subscribe button and the notification bell to stay up to date on all of our daily videos and content. Let's start with the basics. What exactly is metabolism anyway? The Mayo Clinic defines the metabolism as the body's process needed to maintain life. If that definition sounds a little bit nebulous, don't worry. Allow us to break things down a bit further. We most commonly think of the metabolism process as the way in which our body converts food into energy. This process is universal across all living things. Whether you're an animal or a plant, all living creatures require a source of energy to keep functioning. In addition to converting food into fuel, your metabolism covers all other aspects of life such as breathing, digestion, and even repairing your body's cells. In other words, every chemical process in your body that keeps you alive and functional can be traced back to your metabolism. Despite the fact that metabolism covers so many aspects of your life and health, the one thing that people commonly seem to be most concerned with is how it affects your body's weight. When a person demonstrates exceptional weight loss or weight management, people sometimes make the assumption that they have a fast metabolism to help them burn off fat at a faster rate. By the same token, people who seem to struggle with weight loss are typically considered to have a slow metabolism. But how much of this mindset is true? Let us take some of the most popular questions surrounding the topic of metabolism and see what answers experts on the subject can provide. Number 1. Is metabolism genetic? Many people are led to believe that the speed at which your metabolism runs is a genetic trait that each person is born with, and as a result, there's nothing you can do to change it. This can potentially lead to a defeatist mentality among people who appear to have quote-unquote slow metabolisms. After all, if you struggle with weight loss due to a slow metabolism, what's the point in trying to lose weight in the first place if your metabolism is going to fight you every step of the way? The truth of the matter is this. While your metabolism is influenced in part by your genes, the biggest impact on your metabolism's speed depends on your lifestyle choices, aka diet and exercise. Additionally, while a slow metabolism can indeed reduce the rate at which your body burns calories, it's not the only thing to consider when it comes to managing your weight. In fact, a slow metabolism on its own is rarely the cause of weight gain. Ultimately, diet and level of physical activity play the biggest role in that department as well. Another assumption people make about genetics is that skinnier people have metabolisms that are naturally faster. However, this commonly believed metabolism fact is also false. According to Nancy Farrell Allen, spokesperson for the Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics, the real secret to a fast metabolism isn't how skinny you are, but rather, how much muscle mass you have. Allen writes this, "Metabolism depends on the composition of protein mass you have. Muscle is more metabolically active. In other words, building muscle gives your metabolism a boost and causes your body to burn more calories during periods of rest. Because of this, muscle building exercises like weightlifting are ideal ways to give your metabolism a much needed kickstart. More muscle equals more calories burned, and more calories burned equals more weight lost." Number 2. Can you speed up your metabolism? Now that we know how your metabolism functions, the next question on your mind is probably whether or not there's anything you can do to speed up your metabolism and lose weight faster. The short answer is yes. However, some of the ways that people try to speed up their own metabolisms can sometimes be seen as misguided at best and actively hurting your weight loss progress at worst. One popular misconception is that eating several smaller meals throughout the day instead of three larger meals is better for your metabolism in the long run. While this idea has been held as true for a while, new evidence suggests that this meal plan might not be as beneficial as we originally thought. This is primarily due to the fact that eating more meals throughout the day means that you have to work extra hard when it comes to counting calories. According to Allen, a lot of times we tell people to eat 5 or 6 small meals a day. But there's some research coming out saying maybe it's better to eat 2 or 3 modest meals a day. When people hear that they can eat 5 or 6 small meals, they're not eating small meals. In other words, when you split up your daily food intake over 5 or 6 meals, it can potentially become easy to lose track of exactly how much you're eating. For more balanced meal plans, smaller but larger meals make it easier to keep track of your calories, as well as to make sure that the food you're eating contains a veritable amount of vitamins, minerals, and other nutrients. Another way people have tried to give their metabolisms a boost was by taking over-the-counter supplements that claim to speed up your metabolism. Unfortunately, the idea that a pill can boost your metabolism is also wishful thinking, and a supplement will not have any direct impact on your metabolism. This is because the supplements themselves do not contain any calories or energy for your body to use. Additionally, supplements can also come with some potentially dangerous side effects, especially if you happen to be taking any prescription medications. If you think supplements might be an easy shortcut on a path to losing weight, chances are you're likely to be disappointed. So, how can you give your metabolism a much-needed boost? Well, in addition to exercise and building muscle mass, some foods may also have a naturally positive impact on your metabolism as well. Spicy foods such as chili peppers, foods high in iron such as lean meat and lentils, and beverages such as coffee and green tea are all believed to have metabolism-boosting properties. Your metabolism also has a habit of slowing down when you're dehydrated, so drinking plenty of water throughout the day will help your metabolism to run at a maximized efficiency. Number 3. Does your metabolism slow down over time? While it is true that your metabolism slows down as you get older, the effects aren't quite as immediate and sudden as people make it out to be. A lot of people seem to assume that as soon as your 20s are over, you can expect to hit a metabolic wall. In actuality, most people won't see their metabolism slow down until they're somewhere around their 50s. Because this coincides with menopause, women are likely to experience this slowdown the most, which can potentially lead to additional weight gain. However, nutritional experts suggest that you can still control your metabolism to an extent by maintaining the same positive lifestyle habits as you get older. In other words, while your metabolism does slow down over time, it doesn't screech to a halt the way that people sometimes expect it to. With these questions answered, you hopefully now have a better understanding of how your body's metabolism works, as well as things you can do in order to keep your metabolism running smoothly. While many people tend to blame their weight loss struggles on slow metabolism, the truth of the matter is that there are still things that you can do to give your metabolism a potential boost and work towards your ideal weight. Did you find this video interesting or informative? Do you have any other questions on the subject that you'd like us to answer in a future video? We value your feedback, so be sure to let us know in the comment section below and help us keep this conversation going. Enjoyed this video? Hit the like button and share with your friends. Also, subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.